In today's episode, our UK tour continues as we head to Barnard Castle in County Durham. We enjoy some fantastic walking trails that end up at pubs. We spend a lot of time drinking pints in gorgeous local pubs. And we visit England's most spectacular waterfall, High Force.
Help, Stacey's driving again.
I'm hoping for a better approach this time.
No.
What do we go? It's not okay.
We were on our way to one of our favourite places in the UK, Barnard Castle. And, luckily for Stacey, she did have an easy route, as the roads around here are all rather good. Though I am sure that if I looked hard enough, I could find her some dodgy ones. Along the route, we passed through beautiful villages, saw gorgeous cottages, and we even got to see this incredible traditional horse-drawn gypsy wagon. In fact, there were quite a few of these about, as the gypsies and their horses were on their way north towards Appleby for the annual horse fair.
Just coming through Barnard Castle, Stace gets quite excited because she really likes it. It is a gorgeous, gorgeous place.
No, this is where I want to settle down. Not like right in the town, but this area. I just love it so much.
Fun fact, we spent our honeymoon up here, didn't we?
We did, yeah.
We did.
It's really nice.
So, yeah. And I used to holiday a lot here as a kid. I've probably mentioned that numerous times before.
Oh,
used
a couple of fish and chips.
That's the main reason why Stace's excited. Nice fish and chip shop just across the road there.
I wonder if the curry house here, that'd be better.
I think you just need to focus on getting to the campsite.
Right, Jamie said, because of the queues at the airports, and he is right, that we shouldn't go abroad. We were going to go abroad this week, but we decided that it wasn't really worth doing. So here we are in the caravan instead, which, you know, that's better. But I did say to him, we've probably saved ourselves like 1,200 quid, so he owes me a couple of meals out, I reckon. Come on.
We need to sell a few more Fox and Caravan gifts before we can afford
buy
the curry.
Buy journals, guys, and I'll get chips. Oh, are you dining?
Nearly just ran this person over. But terror in first gear.
He seems to have missed the crossing that's just behind us. So never mind.
But yeah, Barnard Castle is stunning. And I don't ironically have my glasses on today. It's just my eyes are really sore from yesterday. So I'm not testing my eyesight here or anything like that. But Barnard Castle.
It's gorgeous.
It's a gorgeous little town. Really urge you to come and take a look at it, but we'll show you around.
To rip off Wikipedia, Barnard Castle is a market town on the north bank of the River Tees in County Durham, named after and built around a medieval castle ruin. The town's Bowes Museum has an 18th century silver swan automaton exhibit and paintings by Goya and El Greco. We didn't visit the museum on this occasion, but have done so in the past. Last time we went together, Stacey and myself both picked out this painting as our favourite, which we only discovered after we'd returned home.
Right, so you're going to go down past the toy shop now.
We were staying at Pecknell Farm campsite, just outside the town of Barnard Castle on the B6277. It's on the same stretch of road as the camping and caravanning club site, as well as the caravan and motorhome club campsite. We couldn't get booked into either of the two club sites, which is why we ended up at Pecknell Farm. Barnard Castle was about a 30-minute walk from the campsite along a completely traffic-free route, and in the evening sun, it was an incredibly pleasant stroll. You may have noticed that Stacey's hair has changed colour. Don't panic, it's not your eyes that need testing. Stacey has a side hustle in testing and reviewing wigs. We had fully intended to photograph our food for you, but we got carried away by our hunger and totally forgot. So here's a picture of us raising a glass of cider to Barnard Castle.
Oh wow, what an amazing evening we've got here. We've just come back from Barnard Castle where we've had a lovely portion of either jumbo sausage and chips, and you had some...
I have scampi.
Scampi and chips with curry sauce, nonetheless,
obviously. We are in the north.
And now we're just walking back. Got the castle in the background just there, look. Barnard Castle weir.
Sorry. Must just be the cider we had on the picnic though.
And we had a few ciders whilst sitting
like
in the castle gardens.
We're like 14-year-olds drinking ciders in the park. You know?
How was the glasses, plastic, not cans? Yes.
Plastic glasses.
Oh, nearly lost me here. Sunglasses. So yes, so a lovely evening really, and we're not far. It's about a 25-minute walk to Barnard Castle.
We don't really walk very fast.
From where we're staying.
It's a healthy stroll if you're going to have
healthy
a
healthy stroll, yes. I think you can...
I don't think we'll have walked them off, maybe, but...
No, I don't think we will have, but you can definitely justify a portion of chips from the chip shop in Barnard Castle.
Also, despite it being early June, we are like well coated up because it's blooming freezing.
Yeah, it's cold still, do you know?
The sun's got some intensity in it, but the wind is really icy.
Yeah, well, I got burnt the other day, didn't I? So, at the fair.
Yeah, but it was, again, it was breezy, so you don't really notice the warmth.
Yeah, so, come on, northerly wind. That's you know, let's get some warmth from the south, please.
We're going to be, like, drawing in for... No, just no.
So, anyway.
It's going to rain tomorrow.
Anyway, is there a horse here?
There's a horse in this house.
Okay, yep. Moving on. So we're going to head back to the campsite now along the same path along which we came.
Yep.
That was wordy. And how many ciders did we have? Anyway.
We had a whole one and a half each.
We're walking home. Beautiful light.
Turn it around, the trees look nice.
Turn it around, the trees look nice.
They do.
Yes, indeed they do. To a lovely little place called Romaldkirk, which is just up the Tees Valley, and we are going to walk to a special place called the Fairy Cupboards, where you leave a little bit of money and the fairies grant you a wish. So it's very sweet, isn't it?
We had our honeymoon in Romaldkirk.
Yes, we honeymooned up there and we left some money last time. I think we left euros for some strange reason.
We thought they might give us the Euro Millions, but
yeah, and we left quite a modest wish. And I think they've all come true, haven't they, our wishes? So we're going to leave some more money there today for the fairies, and we'll make some more wishes. So we'll take you along for the ride. It's a beautiful walk. So you thought that house would be how much, Stace?
345,000.
And it was how much?
525,000.
Yes, gorgeous little property overlooking the village green here.
It's bigger than the forest.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, it's half a million.
But your £345,000 would be a good deposit, wouldn't it?
Might be able to buy the barn.
Might be. There you are. That's more your ability there. A nice garage. Oh dearie me. Yes, Romaldkirk is beautiful, but you do pay for it, don't you? It's quite a pricey little place. But do you know what?
Come on,
you know, it's gorgeous, isn't it? Absolutely gorgeous. So we're going to have a little walk down from here to the river. We're going to walk along the river, find the fairy cupboards. Ooh, that's where we stayed, look,
on our honeymoon down... Was it that one?
No, I think it was through that gate.
Anyway.
Yeah, Romaldkirk.
Ah, there we are. We stayed there on our honeymoon many years ago. But... are we going the right way, or are we at this one's property?
I thought you were just coming down here to look at this.
Oh, right. Yes, it is. So yes, Romaldkirk is a gorgeous, gorgeous little village, well worth a visit. They do an amazing summer fair here in August. Is that on that one?
I thought it was not.
Anyway, they do an amazing summer fair here in August, which is well worth a visit if you're in the area. Sadly, we won't be. We tried to engineer it so that we would be, but it didn't work out. Anyway, enough garbling from me. Let's look at the scenery. Stacey's daydreaming again.
We came across this house years ago when we were last down here, and we just thought it was the most perfect little farmhouse, and we just imagined all the wonderful things we could do here with this sort of pasture here and that house. And it's good to, what is good to see is it hasn't really fallen into any great ear level decay since we were last here, because a lot of these places the roofs collapse in and then you just get rapid deterioration. Yeah, you could get a caravan down that track, couldn't you? So yeah, if you're the landowner and you know you own this property, we could make you an offer. And here they are, the fairy cupboards. You can see why they're called cupboards, because of the way they're carved into the rock. Now, traditionally, you leave a gift for the fairies of money. So we're gonna do that, and we're also gonna make our wishes, and we'll see if they come true, eh?
We might be leaving the carcass of a border collie to wait
for it.
We might have to sacrifice the dog to the fairies.
For a dog that's got arthritis, it's not doing too bad today, huh? So yeah, we're gonna leave some money, make a wish, and we'll see if it comes true.
No, we're not that desperate.
The fairy cupboards are a special little place, so I'm not going to give you a Google drop pin or what three words location for finding them. But if you walk along the Tees River Way from Romaldkirk in the direction of Cotherstone, keep an eye out for this large flat slab in the river. Climb down to here, look back, and you will find them. The rest of the walk takes you along the river, up into Pleasant Meadows, before dropping you back to the river as the Cotherstone footbridge comes into view. However, we were headed towards Cotherstone village, so we kept right and followed the path around to the smaller Boulder Bridge, which takes you up the hill towards the village. We discovered both pubs to be shut due to the local village fair happening, so we decided to head back to Romaldkirk along the stunning railway path. We'd had a thoroughly enjoyable walk and enjoyed every last drop of this cider at the Rose and Crown pub in Romaldkirk. Hello, it's Monday the 6th of June. We're still at the Barnard Castle campsite, or the campsite near Barnard Castle anyway, I should say. And today we've done a lot of work in the morning.
Yeah.
Packing orders, which
we've
has
had,
been awesome.
We ran a sale on my website over the Jubilee weekend, and so we've had about nearly 80 orders, didn't we, to pack?
Yeah. So. Pretty manic. Pretty.
Didn't sound much, but when you're only doing it in a caravan, trust me, it's a lot.
So we've done all that this morning, and we've been out and we've picked up some groceries and some other bits and pieces. And now we've decided that we're in need of a pint. Sorry, that was a crane fly or something on my arm. So we're going to have a little walk to Cotherstone, which is about 2 miles from the campsite.
You might have seen us there yesterday failing to get a pint.
Yes, we're determined to get a pint at the Red Lion or the Fox and Hounds, one of the two. So we're actually walking along the old railway line. It's not actually designated as a footpath. The cycleway that's quite famous in this area runs from Cotherstone up to Middleton and Teesdale, but this section south of Cotherstone hasn't yet been developed. But as you can see, probably behind us, it's a good enough footpath. There is a footpath that runs parallel, official footpath that runs that way, but it's super overgrown, so I don't think many people actually walk it. I think most people just clamber up onto this. And from the campsite, you can actually, there's a really good, easy way up on top, which I'll show you on the map. But yeah, let's hopefully go along to Cotherstone and get a cider.
Second time lucky.
Okay.
those ones we had before that had the cat or the castles on was pretty epic.
So funny story, when we were here on our honeymoon back in 2015, we took the dog for a walk through some fields near Cotherstone, and we rounded a corner to an entire sort of herd of heifers with newborn calves. Is that the correct term, or are they heifers before they calve? Anyway, you farming types can correct me on that. And the dog got spooked and started yap, 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 yap. And then what happened was the calves actually started charging us. And so I had to sort of stand between Stace and the dog and the cows and sort of scare them away. And I thought, I was just seeing the headlines flashing through my mind, you know, man on honeymoon stampeded to death in Cotherstone. But fortunately it was okay. I mean, what we should have done, we later found out, is we should have just let the dog off the leash, because they were more interested in the dog than they were in us. And actually the dog's got more chance of getting away, even if it is trampled a little bit. But anyway, it was young at the time, it could have taken the trampling, I reckon. So so there we are, that was our little bit of learning. Right, we're getting back up the railway line in a minute, and we've got to lift the dog across its nemesis, which is a cattle grid. We've escaped the trappings of a caravan for another walk today. We're going to walk from low force up to high force, and we've parked at the Bowleys Nature Reserve car park. It's a pay by donation for the car park, which is I think a really nice scheme actually, because you can pay what you can afford. There's a lovely little stream and a river just behind me, but I've not taken any footage of it because there's a school group currently using it, and you know,
it's not really the done thing to film school children.
No, okay. No,
so, it's not acceptable these days.
But you guys won't know, because what I'll do is I'll cunningly film it on the way back and then just drop it in. You
see, they will know because you just told them.
Right, oh, but anyway, so we're gonna have a little walk up from low force to high force. It's about 3 kilometres to high force from here, so it's not
low
far.
Low force and high force are waterfalls, by the way.
I think the viewers know that High Force is England's most magnificent waterfall. Anyway, we'll take you along.
Low Force, actually.
Oh,
I think they've got it wrong.
You would, wouldn't you?
Yeah, I'm hoping that I have an ice cream at the other descent on the way back as well.
Well, if you behave yourself, I might give you a coffee and ice cream. This is a cool old suspension bridge, and it says one person at a time, and anybody found rocking the bridge on purpose will be prosecuted. Sounds like they've had a few problems there in the past. Gorgeous.
And there we are, folks. That's the end of our little few days away at Barnard Castle. We're heading home to Wales today. We've got about 7 days, 10 days in Wales, where we've got a chance to restock, do a couple of repairs that need doing. And then we're heading back out for the Royal Cheshire Show, and also the making our way down to Devon for the Royal Devon Show as well. So we've got a good few weeks ahead of us of touring. I think about 6 weeks after this week off. So really looking forward to it. Had a really nice time here at this site. It's really nicely kept, and everyone's very friendly, and the pictures are nice. They're very strict on dogs here, so if you've got your dog, it's got to be on a lead at all times, and absolutely zero fouling allowed on the site. So yeah, really nice site overall. If you do come here, make sure you've got your long hookup lead. We've got a 30 meter lead, and we're on pitch 10 at the moment, and the 30 meter lead just made it to the hookup point, so something to consider if you come here. We took the option of the hookup because it was included in the price anyway, so it made sense just to plug in. And because we had to do all those orders yesterday, it made a lot of sense because we could just run all the laptops and everything else without, you know, hammering the inverter, so it was just easier. But yeah, really nice few days here. Could easily spend another week up here, but we've got things to do back in Wales, so we've got to go. So we're just about ready to wind up the legs, and we'll be going on our way. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.